Learning from the Legacy, a case for Kalyan City. It is said that ancient India had a population of 600 lakhs, a testament of the resources for its geographical setting and climatic conditions. The Seleucid and the Ptolemaic Egypt were at war trying to comprehend each other with the wealth and the might of the army. The former was constantly supplied with elephants from India, but the Ptolemaic, who were not so fortunate, that had to use the Red Sea route for the pachyderms. It was through this trade that the seafaring prowess of the ancient Indians was discovered when they chanced upon a lone Indian sailor from shipwreck. He offered to guide any ship that would return him to India as an exchange. Eudoxus commanded the voyage, the first ever direct access with India. The mariner revealed the magic of the monsoon wind, and hence the name Monsoon Marketplace, dash allowing the journey to India within weeks. Gifts were exchanged and trade deals were made with Raja. Thus, began a crucial trade economy. Augustine era witnessed 27,000 tons of goods being traded via the 120 merchant vessels, annually costing them approximately 800 million sesterces. The influence of the dynasties that changed the landscape of the region, for instance the Satavahanas through the Nanagat Pass, changed movement of the traders. This and other influences allowed Kalyan to thrive as an important port, owing to its geographical character, bringing together many cultural exchanges and their influences. The stimuli to the change brought about by these influences had responses specific with time. In one instance, it was a peace-loving trader's haven, enjoying the multitude of religion and cultures being exchanged through trade, while another, a significant stronghold for Shivaji Maharaj to build a naval armada. The glory of the Kalyan and other inland and coastal ports declined with the emergence of the island city of Bombay, Mumbai. Kalyan, in recent time, continued to be inhabited by the middle working class who preferred the affordable housing and traveled out of the city for work, and irony where in past people came here for trade. This could be said to have brought the deterioration in the cultural significance of the inherited landmarks of the ancient city. The significance of the cultural markers like the Durgadi Fort and the Ajadu bring an occasional percentage of tourists and is also used for the celebration of festivals, but one has to see if the use is for lack of alternative space or for its significance in time. Kalyan is said to be an emerging city, and the recent trends have already seen a flurry of new developments in infrastructure in housing and commercial sectors. The recent boom also poses a contrasting challenge, that of the people who not part of city, for the daily travel out of the city for work, while the others migrating permanently for its affordability. In either scenario, the cultural significance of Kalyan is threatened. The evolution of Kalyan as one of the important ports of the ancient India highlights the inheritance of the claim, witnessing an exchange of cultural values through the process of trade, colonization, reconciliation, and relocation. The design approach for Kalyan specifically entails to question the open spaces as per the smart city development and reinvigorate the need to look at parks and public spaces as unifying attributes for a stronger cultural integration. The park intends to address the vital issues of resilience against climate change, ecological and sensitive upgradation, land conservation and carbon sequestration, remediation of hazardous waste, and inclusivity in design.